What's going on, guys? Jay from MedSchoolInsiders.com. Many of you have asked for a tutorial on one of my favorite productivity apps, Evernote. To give you a brief overview, Evernote is a powerful note-taking application. I use it as my main tool for organizing notes in medical school. Its main competitors at the current moment are Microsoft's OneNote and Apple's Notes. This, however, is not a comparison video. Evernote's strength is in its search function. You don't have to worry about meticulously organizing your notes in order to find what you are looking for. You can throw all your notes, ideas, and projects at Evernote, and it will help you manage them all with minimal effort. In this video, I'll be giving you a brief overview of how to use Evernote effectively as a student. So how do you actually use Evernote? It's organized into a series of notebooks and notes. You can also make stacks, which are groups of notebooks, like this one here, which is MS1 for the first year of medical school. As a student, I created stacks for each of my years in medical school. And within those stacks, I created notebooks for each subject or block. So if you're a college student, I would use course titles or descriptions like chemistry, physics, English, etc. For med school, there are systems like cardiology, gastroenterology, hematology, etc. So let's look at a quick example to demonstrate. Within the first year, I took MSK, which is musculoskeletal. I created individual notes for each lecture. I also created condensed notes or summary sheets for each lecture to facilitate a more active learning process. In the note for the lecture, I imported the PDF document that the professor shared with us. In Evernote, you can insert files within your note, so I often place either the PowerPoint or PDF file that accompanies the lecture into the Evernote note as a reference. You can then open the file from there and take notes within the document or annotate and save. Again, the search function is Evernote's strength, so the program will actually index the content within the file. Therefore, when you search, you'll also be looking within these documents. So this hierarchy is a more traditional way to organize your notes. Another powerful way to add another level of organization is with tags. You can add several tags to each note. So let's look at some examples. So right here is anatomy. In each block, we were going over relevant anatomy to that system. So for example, in cardiology, we learned about the anatomy of the heart and vasculature. In pulmonology, we learned about lung anatomy. In GI, we learned about the digestive system anatomy, etc. So rather than placing each anatomy lecture in a separate notebook, I tagged each one with anatomy. So if I need to find any notes on anatomy, I can search for this tag, and they all show up here. While I do prefer the convenience, the efficiency, and the flexibility of taking notes digitally, there are definitely advantages to paper notes. Drawing diagrams or taking notes on the go, such as when you're not at a desk, are usually easier with a pen and paper. I combine both and occasionally write notes or draw diagrams in my Moleskine notebook and import the image using my phone's camera. So these handwritten notes can actually be searched. This is a very powerful feature called optical character recognition, or OCR. So Evernote looks at images in your notes to identify text, even handwritten notes. So let's do an example. I'll search for viruses. I know it's a diagram, so I'm gonna put tag diagram. And boom, here we go. So it recognized my handwriting, RNA viruses at the top, and it even highlighted the word viruses within this handwritten diagram that I made. So here's another example. I wrote in an actual notebook and use the scannable app to quickly import the image into Evernote. So my handwriting is absolutely horrendous in this note, but Evernote was still able to recognize a few words, like hand is right there. This was particularly useful for me during third and fourth years of med school, also known as the clinical years, where you are not in the classroom taking notes on your computer. Instead, you're in the hospital, and I would just jot down brief notes on a small notebook just to capture an idea or important pearl. Now, Evernote Premium comes with this handy feature allowing you to annotate either images or documents within or the entire note as a PDF. You can draw arrows, you can add text like this. You can You can add additional notes, etc. So you have a great deal of flexibility with this feature, and you can do the same thing on your mobile device, so whether that's your tablet or your phone. I often used the annotate feature on my iPad when I was going through research articles on PDF and I had a stylus and I could just highlight as if it was real paper on the document. You can also share or collaborate on files or entire notebooks with other people. You can choose whether they can view or also edit the actual note. I honestly don't think that these sharing features are quite as strong as what you can do with Google Docs or Google Drive. But if your friends are using Evernote, it's usually good enough to get the job done. I've used it a few times when dividing up work with a classmate, and it's worked well for us. Now lastly, you can use Evernote completely free, and that's where I recommend that you start. After trying out the free service, you can then decide if it's worth it for you to upgrade. I personally now use the premium service. There is a student discount available on their website. The reason I upgraded from the free service is that with the premium, you get additional storage, the ability to search within documents, the ability to annotate, including on mobile devices, and offline copies on my mobile devices. However, I again recommend that you start with the free version, see how you like it before you upgrade to the premium. I'd like to thank Lecturio for making this video possible. So if you are either a pre-med or med student, this service will definitely benefit you. They provide video lectures by educators from top institutions like Harvard, Yale, and Johns Hopkins. They also provide quiz questions and topic reviews, all of which prepare medical students for USMLE Step 1, Step 2, or Step 3, and pre-meds for the MCAT. They also recently launched a pretty cool feature called Book Matcher, where you take a photo of your book page, whether that's first aid, and it will provide you relevant videos that will help to explain those concepts. So you can learn more here on their website at lecturio.com. They also have some free videos on their YouTube channel. So if you are interested, go to lecturio.com/insider or use the coupon code insider20 for 20% off your subscription. All right, guys, that is it for this video. Thank you all so much for watching. If you liked the video, make sure you press that like button. New videos every week, so hit subscribe if you have not already, and I'll see you guys in that next one.